morning. Welcome.
Morning.
This morning, our presentation focuses on the music of John Sweelinck. John Sweelinck was born in 1562, and left this earth on the 16th of October in 1621. So this is the earliest of our composers we've heard thus far. The music of the Sweelinck straddles the Renaissance and Baroque eras, and Sweelinck is considered the last and probably the greatest of the Netherlandish Renaissance composers, born in Deventer, but lived most of his life in Amsterdam, where he spent 44 years as the organist of the Utkerk there. The testimony to the strength of music in many ways, the Utkerk was originally Roman Catholic, and then as the Reformation took hold, it became Calvinist, and then finally Lutheran. Sweelinck remained organist through all of that time, despite the changes in politics and religious outlook. Again, a testimony to the lasting power of his music. Sweelinck influenced not only the Dutch school, but also the German school, and is in some ways, as he was once called, the maker of organists. His influences extend to Buxtehude, Bach, all the way up through the 20th century, and perhaps stretching it a little bit, there are some elements in Sweelinck's music that actually are found in blues music of the 20th and 21st centuries, specifically his tendency to switch back and forth between major and minor tonalities and occasionally imposing the two on top of each other, as is often done in blues. Sweelinck's fame was such that his colleagues nicknamed him the Orpheus of Amsterdam. So as a performer, of course, if you ask most organists, well, who's your favorite composer? You know, they of course will say, most likely, they'll say Bach, of course. Bach, and with good reason. And some will say Buxtehude, and that's getting closer to my place. But when I first discovered the music of John Pieterszoon Sweelinck, I kind of had a revelatory moment, and I found myself reading through the first Sweelinck score that I had, sitting at the organ, and thinking to myself, now here at last is flesh of my flesh and bone of my bone. This is very much my music. It is a music that I most greatly relate to, and that I'm most intimately connected with. That said, I've also spent a lot of years trying to convince people that it is music at all. We get far enough back, particularly as we begin to plummet the depths of the common practice period, and our ears have changed. Our ears have changed. So some of this Renaissance music doesn't compute even for classical music lovers. So that's the disclaimer, and hopefully you will at least tolerate it and maybe find something of beauty within it. Most of the pieces we're going to hear are abstract pieces with names like Ricercar and Fantasia and Toccata. There are a couple of pieces based on chorale works, specifically Lutheran chorales. When that's the case, I will play the chorale melody, just on the off chance you might recognize it.